Okay, so let's start out with Anna. What would be the first thing you would ask them?
I would first ask, what questions do you all have?
So I'll be honest, I've been watching your videos for a while, Christy. I've been trying to do it on my own, but I've kind of come to a fork in the road of what is the best choice to which debt to tackle next. And my wife, she has never watched any videos, and so she's still a little bit on the fence. So I'm like, we need to have this meeting so she can hear other than from her husband. Because sometimes from your husband, it doesn't sound the same.
True, true. Yeah.
Right. So I guess really as far as questions is what's next? I mean, how would you attack this? That's really all I have.
Well, Anna, I know what you would probably say, but I'm gonna let you answer that.
Well, I mean, I think you guys are in a great position. I mean, you have a great cash flow. Your debts are pretty minimal. So I think a really good option for you all would be the first lien HELOC. And if you went that route, you'd probably have everything paid off in around 4 years. So that'd be your mortgage, credit cards, car, loans, everything.
I love it. She's so good at this. I think I'm gonna let her take over. That is exactly what I was thinking. You're in a great position to be out of debt very quickly. And the only thing that you lack is getting into the first lien. Now, that being said, you couldn't move into the first lien. You couldn't move all of your debt in there yet because you only have, it says 320,000 in value, and Texas only allows an 80% loan to value. So to start out, that would only give you 256,000 for your loan to value, but 210,000 has to come out of that immediately because of the mortgage balance that you have. So to slow that down to where you know what I said, your value is at 320 according to your worksheet. Your loan to value would be 256,000, and that means that is a loan to value of 80% that they allow in Texas. So when your $210,000 comes out to pay off your mortgage, then that means you're going to have $46,000 available to pay off any additional debt that you want to throw in there. When you move your mortgage into a line of credit such as this, every time you get paid, it will go into this line, bringing this balance down, giving you more available credit that then is going to be able to pull in other debt. So, for example, here you could pull in your Toyota and pay it off, and you've gained $772 in cash flow there. Your mortgage now becomes cash flow, that payment, because when your income goes in, just like I teach on the lines of credit, you're going to satisfy this monthly payment. And now all of that money is cash flow, just working this balance down. Tell me what questions that you have about that.
Do you have a question there? Does it make sense?
No, that makes perfect sense. I guess my only question would be, where do you recommend to start with the first lien HELOC? Are there any institutions that you recommend? I mean, we use a credit union, and I don't think that they
They
do.
don't do that. Yeah, I've looked at I looked at a couple of them, but just haven't really because she really wasn't fully on board yet. But if you have recommendations, that'd be great.
Yes. So, Anna, if they want, you could send them to Shane, and he does Texas.
Okay.
So we could let him look at your numbers. I already know what Shane's going to say. You're in too good of a shape not to move into the first lien. It looked like, I believe, you have over 700 credit scores. Yeah. So you have no problems with getting into the first lien. It would just be they're going to verify your income. It takes about 45 days. And the interest rates, the feds came out, I believe it was this morning, and said that they're going to be cutting the rates in September. So that's going to do nothing but help get your debt eliminated. Because I figure at 8.8%, which is high right now because everything's high and we're still winning. So if you take, I'll give you an example. I have people that have just started new mortgages this year and they're at a 6 to 8%, depending on who they are working with bank-wise. When we take and pull that mortgage over into an 8.8% line of credit, it automatically cuts 15 years off of that mortgage. So that's what I'm saying. A mortgage on an amortized schedule compared to your first lien that's in a simple interest based on the average daily balance. Totally two different animals. And of course, that's why they don't show us that. They always push the mortgage on us because the mortgage, even at your rate, you're over 3%. Let's act like you're just 3%. That is actually 60% interest that you are paying. Now, some people look at that and they're like, well, that's a 30-year mortgage. So I kind of get it. But the next best way they get us after they charge the higher interest that they're not telling us about, they front load it to the first 7 years. So they're going to get you for most of the interest in the first 7 years. That's why if you're looking at your bank statements when they come in, you're like, we're not making any progress on this mortgage and we're making our payments every month. Well, it doesn't matter. They're front loading the interest. So you're paying them first and then you get to pay for your house.
I actually just thought of a question when you were speaking.
Okay.
We currently escrow our taxes and insurance, so would that just be something that we just put aside, or we put it on the lien or the HELOC?
Like, yes. So once a year that'll come due and you just pay it out of the HELOC. But
Okay.
until that annual payment comes up, it gets to sit in that balance paying off your home.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah, right now we have all of our bills going through our credit card.
Okay.
And I'm about to try, is it plastic or plastique? I don't know which one, but I'm trying to, this is our first month, first September, we're going to pay our mortgage through it. But if we get this first line, first lien, we could do everything through there.
Yeah, so the plastic gets kind of expensive because I think they just went up to
They did.
4%. Yeah, so that's pretty expensive per payment. And then you're already paying interest on your home too. So try to move into a true line of credit so you're not just paying extra fees. Now, if you had a low credit score and or a high DTI and you're like, I can't get a line of credit, then I'd be like, well, that may be your best option right now. But I
Okay.
think the situation that you guys are in, whether you use the first lien HELOC or you use the Money Max, you're going to be out of debt pretty quickly. So I'd say less than 6 years, regardless of which way you decide to go.
And when it comes to the first lien, how long will they give us? Like, how long will that last?
10 years is a 10-year draw. So I'll
Okay.
give you an example. My second position was in a 10-year draw. It's about to end. So I'm also converting to the first lien HELOC. A couple reasons is one, I didn't know about the first lien HELOC until about 2 years ago. Brand new to me. I'd never heard of it. So excited when I did hear about it. The second reason is after watching what happened in 2008, 9, and 10, where the second position HELOCs were frozen and you could not access them anymore, that was breathtaking. But now with the first lien, none of those were frozen, limits cuts, none called during that time because they're in the first position. So that's why I'm moving is because I think it's a much safer product, to be honest with you. And then two, it gives you more access to more equity. The HELOC that I'm in, I don't remember how they did it, but I think I was at 70% even, and I'm not sure why. But now here in the state of Tennessee, I'll be at a 90% loan to value. So all of the equity I have, I just have 100,000 available to me right now. But when I open it up through the first lien, I could easily have the money to buy another property. So I'm thinking close to 400,000. And that would be pretty awesome to me, to have all of that available because I fund my infinite policies and stuff like that through my HELOCs now. So they can be used for a lot, and I just like having access to that equity.
Yeah. One question I have is for the HELOC. Well, two questions. So you have the HELOC and that your mortgage and everything goes on it as you're paying it down. We're still using our credit cards for all of our payments, and then
Right.
just is it like a balance transfer, or how does that how do you
Okay, so
typically?
I do the exact same thing. I charge everything on a credit card first because I want the rewards and it keeps it off of my line of credit, so why not? So the way yours will work, let's say you have a $100,000 balance and you make $10,000 a month, your income will go into the line. So they give you a checking account with this HELOC. So when you have money go into the checking at 12 midnight, it will automatically transfer into the HELOC. You will use this checking account for everything, like when you go to pay your credit card bills off, you'll pay it through this checking. And say it's $500 that you paid your credit card at 12 midnight, this will transfer out of the checking into the HELOC as well. So if you had 10,000 sitting in the checking that came in and you had 500 that went out, that means that you'll have $9,500 over here in the HELOC now, meaning that this applied to the equity and gave you more equity available, and then they took this 500 back out and paid your credit cards.
Yeah, that makes sense. You
So
just
it's a
essentially
sweep.
are changing banks, if you will, where the money's reducing from. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
So they set everything up for you. They'll give you checks and debit cards. And like you said, I just keep charging on the credit cards. Then when I go to pay them off, I just pay them off through my checking. It sweeps out of my HELOC. And I mean, it's very, very simple to me.